food from plant. In last classes, we have discussed about different types of topics in this chapter. Okay. Now, let us discuss about the another topic. Actually, main topic is paddy cultivation. In paddy cultivation, we discussed about preparation of soil or preparing the soil. Okay. Completely, we have studied about preparing the soil. Okay, next, second step or activity is sowing of seeds. Now we are discussing about the second activity in paddy cultivation. Okay, now types of sowing process or seeding process. Okay, types of seeding process. Types of seeding. Okay, observe. Types of seeding. Sowing process. There are different types of sowing process. There are different sowing practices. There are different sowing practices. Understanding. In some areas, seeding process is done by hand. In some areas, seeding process is done by just spraying. Okay. Next, in some areas, by seed drill. Like this, there are three types of sowing process. Okay, sowing process. Sowing process by hand next sowing process by seed drill. What? Seed drill. These are three very important types of seeding process. Okay, observe one. observe, actually in tari cultivation, actually in paddy cultivation, medicated and germinating germinated medicated and germinated seeds of paddy are dispersed in paddy cultivation field. Paddy cultivation. Paddy cultivation field. Paddy cultivation field. This is important. Observe. Okay. Next, after growth of the plant with 4 to 5 leaves, those small plants, they are called naru. What? Naru. They are uprooted and replanted. Replanted at other field. Okay, this process is called transplantation. Okay, this process is called important one, remember, transplantation. What? Transplantation. Okay, transplantation is also not low. What? Not low. Okay, this is important one. Actually, in these three types of method, sowing by the disperser, this is the suitable practice. This is the suitable practice for the paddy. It is a suitable practice. Observe one. have the types of reading. There are mainly different types of practices. There are mainly three types of serving practices. First one, serving by hand. Next, serving by dispersal. Next, serving by seeding. These are three major types of seeding process, seeding practices, or serving practices. Of these three practices, serving by dispersal is a suitable serving practice, or seed dispersal, seeding practice for the paddy. Here, after medicated and germination, these medicated and germinated seeds of paddy, they are dispersed in paddy cultivation field. Okay, then after 15 to 40 days, we can observe the 4 to 5 leaves. After certain period. Whenever paddy plants are grown 4 to 5 leaves. Whenever they have grown 4 to 5 leaves, then immediately those small plants are uprooted and replanted at other fields. This process is the transplantation, not loop. Okay, important, remember. Okay. Yes, observe once again for a minute. Next, let us discuss an activity. So, what is the aim of this activity? What is the aim of this activity? What is the aim? To collect the information on different seeding, methods used by farmers for different crops, okay. This is the aim of this activity. Okay. Now procedure. Procedure. First, you have to collect the information on seeding method from nearby village farmer. First, you have to go to nearby farm, nearby village. Then, how to meet a farmer. Then how to collect the information on seeding method used by those farmers in that village for different crops. Like this, you have to collect the entire information. After collecting the information, you have to fill or you have to write the entire information in a table. That is the table. Here seeding by dispersal. Next, seeding by hand. Next, seeding by seed drill. This is important. You have to write the different types of crop. You have to write the different types of crop in this table by dispersal, by hand, by seedling, like this. Okay. You have to collect, then you have to write the information in that table. In that table. Okay. Yes. Observe one. Observe, what is the aim of this activity? To collect the information on different seeding methods used by farmers for different crops. This is the aim of this activity. Okay, now procedure. First, you have to go to nearby village and collect the information, collect the information on, collect the information on different on seeding method, seeding method from the farmer, from the farmer. Okay, observe carefully. From the farmer, observe. From the farmer, then you have to write the collected information in this table. Here different crops, seeding by dispersal, like different crops by hand, for example cotton. Okay, for example seed drill, any other plant, any other one, seed drill, for example bajra. Bajra here also dispersal, also here dispersal. For example, bajra. Here cotton. Next, maize. Groundnut. Groundnut. Like this. Like this. How to write the all the crops by using the collected information, by using the collected information. Observe once again. Next, let us discuss about the seed drill. Let us discuss about the seed drill. What is seed drill? It is an instrument It is an instrument used to sow the seed. Sow the seed uniformly. Okay, sow the seed uniformly. Yeah. Important instrument it is, seed drill. Actually, it is a time saving. It is a time saving money saving instruments, time saving and money saving instruments. And other advantage of this instrument is we can sow the seed. We can sow the seed uniformly throughout the field. This is also another important advantage of the seed. Actually, this instrument is attached to tractor. Actually, seed drill, it is attached to tractor. Understanding? When we observe this instrument, it has a funnel-like structure. It has a funnel on the top. Okay, actually farmers place the seeds in the farmers place the seeds in this funnel. Yes. Okay. Then from the funnel, pipes are present up to the plow or up to the knife. Okay, observe carefully. From the funnel. Pipes are present up to knives of plow. Harrow. Understanding? Observe carefully. observe trade drill, it is actually an instrument used to sow the seeds uniformly in the field. Actually, what are the advantages of seed drill? It is a time saving and money saving instrument. We can sow the seed uniformly throughout the field. These are the advantages of the seed drill. Okay, actually it is attached to tractor. Seed drill has a funnel on the top. Farmers place the seeds in this funnel. From the funnel, pipes are present up to 9 of the plow or harrow. Okay, how many pipes are present actually? Actually, 3 pipes are present. How many? 3 pipes. But based on the distance present between the plow, farmers use actually 3 pipes are present. How many? 3 pipes are present. Here, but based on the distance between the plants, farmers use 3 to 6 pipes in seed drill. Understanding? Observe carefully here. Like this, based on the distances, or based on the distances between the plant to plant, farmers use 3 to 6 pipes. Okay, if farmers want to keep the long distances between the two plants, means plant to plant, then they use 3 pipes. Okay, otherwise they use 3 to 6 pipes in seed drill. Okay, actually from the funnel, seeds are traveled through the pipe up to the nails of the harrow, or up to the nails of the harrow or plow. Then what will happen? After seeds are sown in the soil, farmers cover the seeds with soil. Yes. Understanding. Nowadays, seed drill seed drill have the other setup to cover the soil on the seed. to cover the soil on the seed. Like this, seed drill is very important instrument. It is used to sow the seeds in the agriculture field uniformly. But there are some disadvantages. Sometimes what will happen, all seed, there is a chance all seed can be sown at a place. In sometimes what will happen, at some places more seeds are sown, or some places no seeds are sown. Like this, there are some disadvantages of seed drill. Okay, here. Yeah.